Hi, I'm a tutor at UPLATS, and today we would be looking on the hands-on session of Tableau charts and graphs. This presentation is by UPLATS and the details are as given below. Now we have already seen the theoretical concepts and the description of some of the basic charts that we can use for visualization purpose. Let us get some hands-on and see how we can use them one by one. So the first one which we can see is the bar chart. So let us go and look at each one of them. So once you have connected to your sample superstore or any of your relational database or any CSV file, after connecting it to the sheet or the database, we come to your worksheet part where you'll have your dimensions and measures. So now after clicking and seeing the dimensions and measures, you have an option called as Show Me, which will have the kind of the basic visualization of the graphs that Tableau inbuilt has. So you can hover over each one of the graph. Right now they are not selected because we haven't dragged anything into the view. As you can see, the view is blank, so it has been grayed out, but the moment you select any dimension or measure accordingly, the suitable visualization or graphs would be then highlighted. We would see that. So once you hover on the selected graph, you would get what kind of graph is it and the criteria to create that graph, or how many number of dimensions or measures do you need for that. So here you have text tables, you'll have heat maps, highlight maps, you'll have pie charts. These are your maps, geographical maps, horizontal bar, stacked bar, vertical bar, okay, side by side bars, tree maps. Then these are your line, if it is discrete or dual axis. This is your area chart. This is dual combination, histogram, and so on. So these are the basic graphs that you have, but advanced graphs can also be then created in Tableau by writing some code or doing some extra manipulation of data. Okay, so first let us see the bar chart. So we already know how a bar chart looks like. Okay, so we'll have a simple bar chart where we'll use the subcategory and profit. So the easiest way of knowing on which dimension and measure which all graphs are can be applicable is you either select the dimension and the measure. So for example, now I'll have the subcategory. Okay, so for example, let me just look at, so I can just type here and also see the subcategory. Okay, so let us see subcategory. Okay, and then if I need to click on profit, I have to select the option key or the alt key, and when I select this, I would get the visible I would get those graphs visible which can be applicable on these dimensions and measures, as it is one dimension and one measure. So you can also take a pie chart or a tree map or a bar chart or just a heat map. So I would go for bar. So all you have to just click on this particular map. So this is what you get. You get the product subcategory wise. You would get the sum of profit in the bar format. These are your bars. You can then, for example, if you want to change the color of these bars, so you can then put either profit in color. So accordingly, the negative will have a yellowish color and then gradient to blue. So you can change the color. So all you have to do is click on the color palette, select edit colors, and this is the palette. So I can just have red and see, and then I can apply and see how it looked like, and then I can click on OK, for example. Okay, the next option here in marks card is the size. So I can increase or decrease the size of the bars with the size option. Label is wherein I have to show the value. So I can have show mark labels. I can write any text that I want to write. Okay. And so on. Okay. Then details and tooltip is one option wherein when you hover over your bar, you can get this value as the product subcategory name and the sum of profit. So maybe if I don't want the sum of profit as it is already in the right side, I can just remove it. You can preview and you can change the font or accordingly, whatever you want, click on OK. So now I can just see the name. And if you don't want that, you can remove that also. Okay, so this is your bar. In the marks palette, the very main important concept or option is the type of bars and the graphs that you can use. So here you can change bar. You can change this into line also, but then when you change it to line, it is very difficult for any person to understand. So a very important concept or point comes is how you want to represent your data and how easy it would be for the end users or the customers to look at the data and make some meaningful insights and make some business decisions based on these graphs. So by seeing this, maybe for this scenario, this graph is not suited, but maybe for some other scenario or other dimensions, this graph where you have to see a trend or something month-wise or year-wise, that time you can use this particular kind of line chart. Then you'll have area, square. If you just want the text, you can just click on text. And so this is your bar chart. Then if you want to swap it to horizontal or vertical, you can just swap it. So this is how you would then be able to look at. So the profit, whose profit is negative, is accordingly goes in the lower band and so on. So for me, this is the perfect kind of graph that I can use. Okay. Then if I want to change, so I can click on stacked bars also. Okay. So where this each color will have a stack. So appliances is of dark blue color, bookcases of orange color, and it's in a stack format. So that's how you can change this. And so this is how you can click on horizontal or vertical reallocation of bar charts. Okay, so this is how your bar chart will look like. So I can just rename this as bar charts, and then we've already seen how does bar chart looks like. Okay, so you can change the color, the size, the label depending on your requirement. Okay, now let us see how would a line chart look like. So maybe I would take the ship mode and the sales option, and let me first just click on bar, and then here in the automatic option, let me go and change it to line. So this is how your ship mode and sum of sales would work. Okay, then you can also change the rows and column. You can swap it. So this is how ship mode for delivery, truck, express, air, regular air, and these are the sum of sales. Here you can click on T button. That means show mark labels would give you your text. Okay, so this is how your line graph can work. Okay, so this was one option where you can see how your line chart looks like. And you can change the color or whatever you want. Okay, for pie chart, let us see region wise sum of profit. So this is your line chart. You can change the color. For example, if I want ship mode to be colored, so all I have to do is drag this here in color, and then I would get the color, but it doesn't make much difference. Okay, so color you can change when you'll have a bar or an area where which consume some space. Okay, then let us see how does pie chart works like. So maybe region wise, if I want to look at the shipping cost, for example. So select that, and then I can go for pie chart. So this is how your pie chart looks like, where you can increase the size of your pie chart. Okay, and you can even show the text label or whatever you want. If you want the region, to be highlighted, so we can click on region and add in detail or label as well. So here you would get the region. Okay, so this is how your pie chart works like. So region West has a shipping cost of 29,408, and similarly Central and this, and you can change it into a percentage format also. Okay, so you can just do some quick table calculations like the percent of total, and then click on this. Let us see if I can just add the shipping cost into the label as well. And now if I can just have the percent of total on this. So this would be, so this says that percentage of total shipping cost for West is 25%, for Central is 31% of the whole. So if you add up all this, this sums up to 100%. So those were the advanced calculations which would be which we would be covering in Tableau Advanced Concepts, along with some other advanced visualizations as well. But for now, this is the simple one, basic one. Okay, so this is how your pie charts would work, and then you can just drill it down and add whatever you want. Cross tab is nothing but your text chart. So I can have a text graph, this one, or highlight tables, or this, your text tables. Okay, so if I just want product name and product container, product name and profit. So product name wise, I can get the profit. Then I can also add the product container here. So product container wise also I'll get the profit and so on. So this is your normal text format. Okay. It's a very simple one, a text format. Then comes is your tree map. So let us see ship mode wise the profit. So I'll take the ship mode. And then I'll select the profit, and then I would go for heat maps and highlight tables. Okay, and here you'll have tree maps. So we'll see one by one each one of them. So let us first see tree map. So this is how the ship mode, accordingly to the size or the profit, sum of profit of the ship mode would be then the size and the color of these rectangular boxes. Okay, you can change the shape also. Okay, so you can make it circle or whatever shape you want. You can even make it circle. So this also makes some sense, wherein you can remove the text or add the text and so on. Okay, and if you want, you can just print the profit inside the circle below the ship mode value. Okay, so this is your tree map. Then let us see what is a heat map. So ship mode and the profit. So if I click on heat maps, so this is how your heat map would be represented. Okay, so you can change the color, the size, the label and so on. Okay, so we have seen tree maps and heat maps has also been seen how it looks like. This is how it looks like. Okay, so then let us see the next one, which is your scatter plot. Scatter plot. So this is how your scatter plot looks like. So for scatter plot, let me select sales and profit. Sales and profit. sales, profit. So you have to click on the command option, select it. Okay. And then I click on this scatter plot. So this is how your scatter plot will look like. Okay. So once you click on this, then you can change the color. For example, if I wanted product subcategory wise, so this is how it looks like. So for all these subcategories, for example, if I want to look at paper, how much is my profit and how much is my sales? So this is a equation or relation between two measures at the same time, if you want to evaluate these measures. Okay, so in this, you can also have something called as a line or a trend kind of thing with the help of a trend line, okay, which will show you the trend of how these two measures are related or equivalent to each other, finding through some statistical functions like R squared and P value. So this we can then look in the advanced part of Tableau, where we would cover all the topics of analytics as well. Okay, so this was your scatter plot. Then comes is your area chart. Okay, so for example, order date wise, if I want to look at the quantity. Okay, so let me click on order date. Okay, and let me click on quantity ordered new, for example. And then these are the highlighted graphs that are visible. So let me click on this area chart. Okay, so this is your year, so you can drill it down. So this becomes then your quarter or your month of order date. And maybe with the quantity or something, you can change the color. So maybe product subcategory, if I put in color. So this is how this area is consumed, and this is how for each product subcategory and area of your quantity ordered for that particular month of order date would be then displayed or visualized. Okay, so this is how your area chart looks like. Then let us just see one more, which is your dual axis. Okay, so in this line chart, if I have sum of sales here and I would like to drag sum of profit along to it. So these are two line charts, but they are different or independent to each other. But now we want them to be correlated or together. So all you have to do is click on that dimension. Okay. And then click on dual axis. So this is how your dual axis would work like. So sum of sales, maybe I can have as a bar. And this is your sum of profit as a line. And you can change the color and you can synchronize your axis. You can change the mark type and so on. Okay. So you can right click your synchronize your axis, where both these axes would then be coming in the same format or together. Synchronize axis, and more in depth about dual axis we would be covering in the advanced part as well. Okay, so this was your dual axis, where you can take your quantity on year of date and sales together and display that. Okay, and last but not the least is your histogram. Okay, so let me just create one and show you. So histogram, so maybe profit if I select, and automatically histogram, because it needs one measure, so it has been created. And when I click on this, so these are the bins that have been automatically been created. Okay, so there are other advanced charts as well, like Gantt chart, bullet graphs, pack bubbles, Bosk and Whisker graph, and so on. So like you'll have circle views and all. So more advanced graphs we would be then taking up in the Tableau advanced topic. So for the basic type of charts, we have covered all the charts that we can create. Even the map or the geo location and all would be then seen in the advanced section. So creating a graph is very simple, but which kind of graph to be created on which dimensions and which measures is a very tricky part. And you would get to know that the more you get hands-on on all these graphs and based on the requirement, so you can toggle around with the one dimension and measure, and you can try multiple graphs on that, and you can see which graph makes actual sense and which would be easily understood by any lame person. So that's when the real challenge comes for creating visualizations. So thank you very much. So till now we have covered the very basics of Tableau Desktop. I would then also be including the advanced topics that I would be covering up in this session. So please have a look at it. And if you want to know more about the advanced session, then please enroll yourself for the advanced recording part. And happy learning, Tableau. So thank you very much.